A network of volunteers is on the lookout for large masses of floating invasive plants in lakes and ponds in the region. Conservation correspondent Bridget Butler has the story.
Chip and Joanne Wright have summered on Lake Iroquois since the early 1970s. They say there have always been pond weeds, but it wasn't until the 90s that an invasive weed showed up.
I think this is milfoil in the middle.
Milfoil chokes out native aquatic plants, and it grows to form dense mats that can mean trouble for swimmers and boaters.
Look at this stuff, though. Yeah! I could pull all day.
Now the couple helps track invasives on the lake and keeps an eye out for new ones.
It grew out of a desire to help in any way, and a fear too, really, because we knew we had the milfoil.
With over 800 lakes and ponds in Vermont, the state has a lot of water to cover when it comes to invasive species. That's why they're looking to volunteers for some help.
You can see right on the surface there is some Eurasian water milfoil that's just coming up.
Bethany Sargent coordinates the Vermont Invasive Patrollers Program. She says they've trained about 160 people, but could use more.
We teach them really the nuts and bolts of what aquatic invasive species is, what are the species that we're most concerned about, and then give them some of the skills that they need to identify them.
Sargent says the volunteers enjoy being out on the water and care deeply about fighting invasives.
Well, it's really an early detection program, so if we can learn about a new invasive before it has a chance to get established in a lake or pond, then we have more management options.
Sometimes early detection can help eradicate a plant, or at least control the spread.
Once we know that it's in a lake or a pond, then we can make sure that any boats that are coming out of that lake or pond know to take those spread prevention steps so that they don't bring it to another body of water.
Making a little less work for volunteers and a little more time to enjoy the spoils of summer. For Echo and News Channel 5, I'm conservation correspondent Bridget Butler.